हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर एस बी कोल्ले, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजिक्स, शिवाजी कॉलेज कन्नड, डिस्ट्रिक्ट औरंगाबाद। टुडे वी विल स्टडी रेडियल एंड सिलेंड्रिकल फ्लो ऑफ हीट। सो स्टूडेंट्स, अकॉर्डिंग टू फोरियर्स लॉ ऑफ हीट कंडक्शन, नो इट इज़ फॉर रेक्टेंगुलर सॉलिड मटेरियल। नो हियर यू कैन सी ब्लॉक। One phase of the block is at temperature capital T1 and opposite phase of that block is at temperature capital T2. Now distance between these two phases is delta x and qx is flow of heat in x direction. Now this flow is linear. So this heat flow, heat in x direction is given by qx is equal to minus ka dt by dx. Here k is coefficient of thermal conductivity, a is cross sectional area across which heat flows, and dt by dx is temperature gradient, means change in temperature with respect to distance. Now this is for rectangular solid surface. Now we will see for radial flow of heat. Here in second figure you can see spherical shells are there, two shells of radius R1 and R2, and temperatures of inner shell is theta 1 and temperature of outer shell is theta 2. Here heat flow is given by equation q is equal to minus ka d theta by dr. Here flow is radial, k is constant of, means it is called coefficient of thermal conductivity, a is surface area of sphere, and d theta by dr is temperature gradient. Now students, first we will see radial flow of heat or spherical shell method. In this diagram you can see spherical shells A and B of radius R1 and R2 respectively. Temperature of A shell is theta 1, that of B shell is theta 2. Now specimen is contained between A and B shell. Now consider one imaginary shell of radius R and thickness dr, and temperature of this imaginary shell, means inner side temperature is theta and outer side temperature is theta plus d theta. Now quantity of heat conducted per second through this shell according to Fourier's law of heat conduction. This shell means that imaginary shell, and you know heating element is placed at the center of that shells. So from that element heat is conducted radially from shell A to shell B through that imaginary shell. So it is given by q is equal to minus ka d theta by dr, equation first. Now here area is 4 pi r square, spherical surface. So area is 4 pi r square. So if we put value of this A in equation first, we can write q is equal to minus k, and A means 4 pi r square into d theta by dr. Now separate variables, means separating variables, dr by r square is equal to minus 4 pi k upon q into d theta. Integrating this equation, integrating dr by r square between limits r1 to r2 is equal to minus 4 pi k upon q outside the integration, and integration of d theta between limits theta 1 to theta 2. Now integration of dr by r square is minus 1 upon r. If we put limits, we can write 1 upon r1 minus 1 upon r2 is equal to 4 pi k upon q is the constant, and integration of d theta is theta. And if we put limits, we can write theta 1 minus theta 2, means it is totally 4 pi k into theta 1 minus theta 2 upon q. So from this simplifying, we can write k is equal to q into r2 minus r1 upon 4 pi r1 r2 into theta 1 minus theta 2. Equation 2. From this equation, we can calculate coefficient of thermal conductivity k. Now friends, we will see now cylindrical flow of heat. In this figure, see, cylinder is shown, cylindrical tube is shown. Now heat conduction is radial across the wall of the tube. Now see in this figure, inner surface is of radius r1, and outer radius of that tube is r2. Inner radius is r1, outer radius is r2, and temperature of inner surface is theta 1, and temperature of outer surface of that cylindrical tube is theta 2. Now consider element of radius r, and temperature of this element at inner side is theta, and outer side it is theta plus d theta, and its thickness is dr. Now heating element is placed at the center of this tube, and heat is conducted radially across the wall of the tube. Now we will see the expression. Quantity of heat flowing per second across the element is given by q is equal to minus ka d theta by dr. Here area is 2 pi rl. So q is equal to minus 2 pi k rl into d theta by dr. So q into dr by r is equal to minus 2 pi kl d theta. We have separated here variables. R is on one side and on another side there is theta. So integrating equation first. So q outside the integration sign, and integration of dr by r between limits r1 to r2 is equal to minus 2 pi kl integration of d theta between limits theta 1 to theta 2. So q log of r2 upon r1 to the base e is equal to minus 2 pi kl theta 2 minus theta 1. So q log r2 upon r1 to the base e is equal to 2 pi kl theta 1 minus theta 2. Here we have changed the sign, means theta 1 minus theta 2. So minus minus plus. So from this we can calculate k. K is equal to q log r2 upon r1 to the base e upon 2 pi l into theta 1 minus theta 2. Equation second. And if we remove base e to we can change base e to base 10. So k is equal to q into 2.3026 into log r2 upon r1 to the base 10 upon 2 pi l theta 1 minus theta 2. Equation 3. These are the references I have used for preparation of this PowerPoint presentation. Thank you.